Crackers.
Presents.
Carols.
Home Alone.
Nah. Elf.
Brussels sprouts?
What? You are so strange, Hannah Porter.
We said the best things about Christmas, not the worst.
Ugh. Oh, sorry.
It's coming! Once again, Christmas is upon us.
And I'm sure that if you're anything like us, you're desperately trying to get ready for what is probably the busiest season of the year.
As the song says, it's the most wonderful time of the year for many. But what's the best part for you?
We love Christmas.
Literally everything about Christmas is brilliant. Even the Brussels sprouts.
But we have noticed one thing. Christmas appears to be more and more about money.
According to the Bank of England, a typical household spends £800 more in December than their monthly average.
Compared to a typical month, people spend on average 16% more on food, 43% more on clothing, and a whopping 116% more on music and DVDs.
In our desire for the perfect Christmas, are we missing out on something important?
As we get caught up in the busyness of the season, could we be overlooking something?
Social media driven age, everything happens really fast.
Blink and you miss it.
But maybe there's more.
We think a lot of people have a picture perfect view of Christmas.
A lovely stable scene, a beautiful baby, that in the carol appears to be the first baby never to cry.
Not sure about the crying bit. He was a baby after all.
The first Christmas was really rather different.
It's actually much grittier than what you might remember from primary school nativity plays.
Here's spoken word artist Meg Cannon bringing home the reality of what happened over 2,000 years ago.
Mary was 13 or 14 when an angel appeared, telling her not to fear, but God was near. She agreed to carry and deliver a child that the story says would go on to save the world. But first, she had to travel over 80 miles with Joseph by her side, which was not an easy ride for someone who's 9 months pregnant. But along the route they traveled, I've read that robbers and lions were a danger, and you don't see lions in the Nativity standing there next to the manger. But finally they arrive in Bethlehem. Joseph is desperate to find a place for his wife, who's ready to bring this new life into the world. But no relative, no person would give them a space. There was no place for them, no comfort for these travellers. And after 80 long miles, and with sore feet, I'm sure, they were offered a stable floor. And the stable was actually said to be a cave. And there on that day, in the dirt and the hay and the dark and the cold, Mary first got to hold her son. And so these teenagers find themselves alone, so far from home, on the floor where the animals are kept, no doubt in shock as their newborn slept. The story goes that this baby was God come to join us and walk the earth with his people. That he'd teach us about love, peace, forgiveness, seeing all as equal. This baby in their arms would grow to be a man and give up his life for you and me as they drove nails through his hands. And if that really happened, like if that's really true, then what does that mean for me? And what does that mean for you? Like, what if that isn't just a story and God really came to earth in an ordinary way, with an ordinary birth, to show us ordinary people an extraordinary love, a promise of freedom, of peace, of new life, a promise that he cares and wants to know us. So I don't know where you are on the scale of Jesus, truth or fairy tale, but this story still captures the attention of billions over 2,000 years later. And it makes me wonder deep, deep down, what if God really came to town?
Christians believe that Jesus coming to earth is the best news in the world. In the Bible, in the third book of the New Testament, Luke tells us that Jesus is the good news of great joy for all people.
That's an amazing claim. Luke goes on to say that Jesus is three things: Savior, Christ, and Lord.
A Savior is a rescuer. Christ means anointed one. He's the King.
And if you're Lord, it basically means that you're the boss.
If true, then that is the best news that you will ever hear. It'd be good news anytime, but particularly nowadays when things can be really tough.
We hope and pray that you have a great Christmas.
That you get time to rest and enjoy the break, but that you also don't miss the underlying reason for the season.
God bless.
Take care. And Merry Christmas.